them about it?
No, I got my new one.
Oh, you just got
my new one? Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you. Amen.
Yeah.
Yeah. I had a kid like bend back on me today. I was trying to like stop him from crashing through things. And it like bent back and it was fine until like I got home and I was like, I picked up this book and I was like, oh, it's like,
it's not good.
Yeah.
day.
Kate, you're for Kate.
Oh, I just put a message in to figure out where she's at. She might be at work though.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh. So many questions.
Never enough. It's never enough when I come to you. And it's never enough when I
That was impressive.
Thank you. shot of whiskey and my heart. Things slowly began then.
First set, and then we're going to take a break and kind of get situated again and have a second set. Renee will be joining us from vocals and the Lele jamming. Somewhat of a response for Kissing Tree. Like, I have a friend that lives over there, songwriter. She's like, I didn't hear what's song called Kissing Tree.
I love it. Each month we get updated with the saga of Kissing Tree.
I was like, I do. She's like, well, maybe we can, like, we can come out sometime and play on the hill. I'm like, okay, sure. Just let me know when. So perhaps I may get my $1 million.
Selling out, you're buying
in. That's right.
That's right.
Truly, and maybe I live in one.
No, you are selling out. You're selling all the homes in subdivision.
That's right.
All those homes sold out because of you. Nothing wrong with that.
Since you love me, yeah, believe it so. That's what you give for thinking you know. She said, no. Now you're to the kissing tree. Well, I waited all night, and I'm kissing. Well, I didn't think that you had changed. Thank you.
difficult doing all this type moves these days. I can feel like my knees kind of like. Why are you moving like that?
Thank you.
day that B.B. King passed away. It's called Corner Room Blues. Indeed.
It's always the last one, though.
Thank you.
Hey, back.
The day you forget.
Chop, chop.
How'd that put in a writer?
Again, can't be fixed with another amen. Got me
Thank you.
So, kind of our little tribute to New Orleans. Kind of was inspired by the words he wrote, kind of thinking about, going down the Mississippi. Not that I've ever been down the Mississippi, but I've watched boats pass by. So, we did go to Mississippi. And went to New Orleans last two summers ago for the first time, and I just felt like kind of home there. I felt just the energy and the music and everything I'd always thought it would be. So I wrote this one as a tribute to Fats Domino and James Bullard. My original version, I played the limited piano I can play. I can play Fats Domino and Jerry Lee Lewis, but that's about it. We made an arrangement on the guitar, so we hope you like it. It's called Let's Go Down to the Carnival.
One more day to party. Don't know lies that let bon temps rule before they bring them ashes for Wednesday.
Christmas show, but she had to start joining us for more than just Christmas, and so we kind of had a, this month, like, like, well, from Christmas to like now, it seems like it's just been a week. Like, I just put my head just down and like, you're already here at the end of February or end of January. So last weekend we got together and I was like, she said, oh, I've been working on this thing. I was like, perfect, we'll do this and then we'll do this song in a little bit that I'll tell you all about. Can you get that mic?
Ready? I think so. Ready as I'm gonna get. song. She's gonna join me in. I used to teach preschool as well. One summer I was working for this summer camp, and a teacher friend, she knew that I wrote songs, and she's like, well, I would like to write, put music to the song that I wrote. And the inspiration, she had gotten it from her grandfather, who his wife had died. They had been married for 72 years, and she had asked him what was the secret to a long marriage, and he said, always have a never-ending conversation with your wife. Okay, woman?
Yeah.
And so she thought that was, you know, like a wonderful thought. He's like, you know, it doesn't matter if it's good or bad, you don't stop talking. You continue to talk, because otherwise bad stuff will start forming up in your head, and it's all over, you know. So she gave me, and she sang the song, and I took it home and figured out the chords of what she was singing and wrote a little bridge for it, and we put it together. It's called Sail Away Love. So Renee will be singing tonight.
Thank you.
convention next month. We'll be here February 20th. And we'll be doing a set. The second set, we'll be doing some of our favorite Rolling Stones.
And so we're committed.
So, you know, that's always tough. But I think we have a whole lot we're going to do. So anyhow, we hope you will make it out next month as well. I mean, we're glad you're here this month, obviously. So we'll see you February 20th from 7 to 9 again. So we're going to carry on and do a few more songs for y'all. Let's say goodnight. So...
this one's another 10
song Jared wrote. Four lyrics, and I wrote the four.
sell that one to the Hallmark Channel. They're always in need of a good sappy song for that pivotal love moment.
I want to sell it to Oxygen.
This next song we're going to do is called Violet. It's one of the newer songs I've written recently.
Any song with any child that carries snow needs bounce.
Service and two of the guys he used to play with was ex-brother-in-law and their friend, the drummer, guy Matt.
So to clarify, his brother-in-law and I, his ex-brother-in-law and I have known each other since grade school, so again, there was no inappropriate
stuff. That's right.
Oh, man.
We had this big outdoor little deck thing, and we decided to go out there. Well, I wanted to go out there because I wanted him to play, because I didn't really know him other than through stories that I had heard told. And so I remember I started playing the chords of this song, Living on a Prayer, that we're going to do.
Oh, yeah.
So we sat out there and we went through this song about, I don't know, for 15 minutes. We jammed over and over this song. then we played another Bon Jovi song, because I knew John was a big Bon Jovi fan. Growing up, when Bon Jovi got big, I kind of checked out of anything contemporary for about 15 years, and everything was the Beatles and oldies, but we were goofing around a few weeks ago during the break. We did this version of John put together, and so we're gonna do it for y'all now.
He texted me.
Oh, do you like this song? I'm like,
Well, I've been playing this version of this song since high school. That was many, many moons ago. So, hope you guys like it.
Make
So, this next song. So the first song that John and I have written together, I asked him a few years back. He had started coming to when I started playing here. And it was just me. And I knew I needed somebody that could bat was good, to fill out the sound. And so I had asked him to join me. And we started playing together. And so he's like a brother to me. And all these guys are like brothers to me. But they've all been there for me and kind of dark times that I've had in the last few years with my parents passing, there's a lot of other life stuff happening, and so I owe them all. Renee's been there, you know, throughout the last 25 years.
My whole life.
Yes, your whole life, man, back in grade, in the nursery. But I used to go over to her and her parents' house and hang out. Usually I would sit there laughing at mom. Her mom would have a little too much wine, and you know, it was good times. And we played Trivial Pursuit, and she'd get mad and throw that damn board across the room. And I wouldn't know what to do because I was a polite 18-year-old and was like,
"Did she know what you were laughing about?
Yeah, But her family were like, I mean, they're a second family to me as well. You know, they helped me there during those formative years. And we hung out a lot and done a lot of stupid things together. So you're welcome to do. We wouldn't do those things anymore. Unless somebody hurt my kids. And then we saddle it back up to egg houses and toilet paper houses and saran wrap corn and all that other good stuff. John and I got together and we wrote this song, and he had the idea, and we just kind of started tossing lyrics back and forth, and we wrote this song. So.
Puppy dog movie made me cry.
Yeah.
please don't leave before we can. Thank y'all for coming. It means a lot to us. And so this is the first song I wrote this year. I'm in a songwriter's group, but I lost them. But it's called The Soul Riders. So I didn't write this for them. I just wrote the song. And I don't know. You always have this kind of moment of panic when you haven't written a song for a few weeks or a month that you've forgotten how, and like, it kind of stresses you. You start trying to write anything, and it's just nothing's coming to you. And then finally, you just kind of sit there, and then you hear something, you're like, there it is. Like, I haven't forgotten yet. So I was sitting there, and I was kind of thinking about, for my own life, this could be for anybody's life, that sometimes I don't like to quit in situations, but sometimes you have to quit, you have to move on. And it's not so much quitting, but you have to save yourself from a situation that could be bad, because ultimately you are what you have to get through something. And so I wrote this song kind of from my own point of view, but also, anybody who's dealt with stuff in life and needed to get out. Anyhow, it's called Silence Steals the Sound. Thank you. appreciate y'all coming out. We have one more song to do. And the song is called Ever After. And we'll be back out here on February 20th. And we hope to see y'all out here again next month. So.
Thank you.
Jared, John, Marco, Renee. We appreciate y'all coming out. Thank y'all for taking time to come out with us. We'll see y'all February 20th. That's it. Good talk. Thank y'all.
Yeah, that's Voodoo Lab.